idea for this project is to make hardware accelerator that will recognize handwritten digits. The idea is to represent digits like it's shown on the screen, fed network with data and teach it how to recognize digits. The MLP network consists of 4 layers, input, output and 2 hidden layers. Input layer contains 784 nodes. Every hidden layer contains 16 and output 10 nodes. This is an example of digit which I described earlier. 784 tiny pieces are sent to input of network, passed through and the result is recognized digit. Each node is connected to every node in the previous and next layer. Every connection between nodes has their weight, which depends on how is this information important for a node that receives information. We started to design MLP from a really high level abstraction. Here is the Python code which implements feed forward and back propagation network with just 110 lines of code. Next step was to do the same thing using C programming language because it's the language with lower level of abstraction than Python, but still enough high to allow us to write it with much less trouble than using a low-level abstraction programming language system Verilog. All this is used for getting weight coefficients and make it easier to debug RTL model in later stages.
And now we are gonna say a few things about hardware implementation. As diagram shows, there are three AXI interfaces which interact with MLP neural network. Firstly, we load inputs inside block RAM, loading weights and biases follows. After loading needed information, neuron is able to start working on calculations. The result of neuron accumulation is actually needed addresses for getting sigmoid function value from lookup table. Output values from a sigmoid block RAM are stored inside output register. After completing calculations for whole layer, values are sent back to DDR via AXI stream master interface. For proper functioning of network, there is a register map with parameters for setting up network. Depending how we set them, control unit will operate network differently. Now I'm gonna explain how actually networks work in RTL level. As we saw, we have two neurons inside data path, so it basically means we need to load all inputs and weights needed for two of them. We repeat same process for all other nodes inside that layer. At the end, we have outputs which are actually inputs for next layer. For all other layers, process is the same. Output layer have 10 nodes, each node is one digit, and node with the highest value is our recognized digit. This is a process of compiling, simulating and calculating accuracy of our network after floating point to fixed point conversion. As we see, accuracy is 96.4, which is great. Digging deeper inside module, we are able to see all signals in shape of waveforms. Right now, we see each layer values. As it's shown in the third last layer, recognized digit is 5, science value is highest. Next thing we are gonna talk about is usage of camera and HDMI.
At the very beginning of the project, we thought which camera and which communication protocol to use. We chose UCAM3, which as you can see in the picture, has yours communication protocol. When we started with the implementation project, we were thinking whether to use existing IP module or to create a new one. We decided to create a new one in order to get to know UART protocol better. Now we will say a few things about how UART works. In the picture we see that data transfer starting with start bit that has the value of logic 0. Immediately after that we send 8-bit data and at very end we send 1 or 2 stop bits depending on configuration. On the other hand, when we are talking about receiving data, it is obvious that it is starting with the detection of start bit on Eric's line. After we detect the start of transaction, we are taking samples of data from Eric's line. First, we tested the UART module by using simulation. After that, we did a practical test, so we made a loopback communication as it is shown in the picture, where we send data from one side and check it on the another. During the project, we realized that we need somehow to show result we got. So we decided to make HDMI module by which we can show a live picture from the camera and number we will recognize. As we can see in the picture, HDMI module is formed by the video timing generator which needs to produce H-sync, V-sync and draw area signals. There are also three TMDS encoders that have to encode data from the camera. After we encode the data, we serialize them and send. Also, there is one additional component which should create the differential clock signal. By now, we finished only simulation test of HDMI module and results you can see in the picture.